Okay, members of the media, thank you for availing yourself again this afternoon for this progressive media briefing from the National Emergency Operations Center. The situation at the moment, the current warnings, the heavy rain warnings still remain in force for the whole of Fiji, even though we are experiencing some sunshine here in Suva and other areas. The flood warning remains in force for low-lying areas and small streams for the whole of Fiji. Rakiraki Town, Navalau Station, Wailutua, Nayavu, and downstream Wainimbuka Station, including Rewa Bridge, downstream to Nosori. And a flood alert remains in force for the Nombukaluka Station and downstream Nombukaluka River. The water level at Singatoka is steady. However, Yabulo and Nahingatoka villages are still underwater. People living on the Rewa Delta were directed to move to higher ground this afternoon after water levels at the Rewa River surpassed warning levels, and it continues to rise. There is a possibility of Nosori Town being cordoned off and enclosed later this afternoon, depending on the rising of the river. If we have also advised for members of the public, and also the Ministry of Health, to drink to boil drinking water before consumption for health issue. And so far there have not been any reports of fatalities or serious injuries. So in terms of our situation overview, I'll go around for Rakiraki. Major flooding in town area but the water has been receding. The road closed at Nangoro Flats. And the sugar mill is flooded in Tavua, major flooding in Tavua River, in Tavua area. The water is receding and the Tavua Bridge is underwater from Bar Town closed due to flooding, and the Bar River is receding. In Nandi, the town was flooded overnight. The water is receding and the airport is operating as normal. In Sungatoka, the road is closed. And the Queen's Highway there at the Singatoka Melrose Bridge. Navua, low-lying areas flooded, water is receding. In Vonolevu, in Nreketi, a road closed and also crossing off because of water. In Gamea, in Tavioni, there are 6 houses that are being damaged and destroyed. The 17, the health center is damaged, the school is damaged, and the water sources and the food crops are also destroyed. In Nalalawa in Ra, the village is flooded, but the water is receding. In Nosori Town, the town is open, but the road between Oila and Sawani, that is closed, and the road damage in Kasavu, the airport is operating as normal. However, it is of concern that the Rewa River is still rising. In terms of population, the households in tents, as I gave yesterday, has not changed. A total number of 1,817. In terms of evacuation centers, as of this midday today, the number for the Eastern Division remains at 46 with 418 evacuees. For Northern, revised to 21 with 564. For Western Division, 8. Current evacuation centers that are still open with 170 evacuees. For the Central Division, 20 evacuation centers open with 564 occupation. So the total number of evacuation centers that are open has been revised to 95, and the current population in these evacuation centers revised to 1,716. In terms of electricity, there is no planned shutdown of electricity network, but outages can be experienced last night, especially due to lightning strikes. And the power outage remain in various locations, including Dilkusha, Namboro, Ba, and Tavua. And also, there's no supply to the Randariwatu district, the Ra province, and also Nandobi in Rakiraki to Waimadia. So the restoration is also proving difficult for the supply of power to Bundao and Randariwatu and Rakiraki rural areas, as access has been hampered due to flood waters. So in terms of the road, the Queen's Road is closed at Singatoka due to flooding, And the King's Road is now closed at Nongoro Flats due to flooding. The Princess Road, Waila to Sawani, is closed due to flooding. Tavua Bridge is underwater, close to traffic. Yangara Flat Road is underwater and also close to traffic. In terms of the preliminary damage cost, so far we have received agriculture remains at 52,000. That has not been revised. However, Water Authority of Fiji, they have come up with a preliminary estimate of 1.8 million for all their water systems around Fiji. The other sectors, we are still waiting for result to be received. So as we conclude this brief, you would be aware to remind the public to be aware of flooding that is still continuing, especially those in low-lying areas, the need for them to move during daylight to higher grounds or to the evacuation centers. The rescue and evacuation operation by the police and also the military, together with the National Fire Authority, they have now started the cleanup of the Western Division. We would like to emphasize on the need for the community to heed and the restriction of nighttime movement, especially in flooded and low-lying areas. And we would also like to mention for evacuees in the various evacuation centers, they become public places, so we discourage the drinking of Yangona grog and also for smoking. That's the brief for you this afternoon. I'll take questions now, maybe one or two. Thank you.
There's been calls have been made for government to declare flood affected areas disaster zones to enable everyone affected to be provided immediate assistance.
So far, there has not been any decision on that. Yeah.
Can we expect curfew to be put in place this afternoon?
Curfew? Yeah. From the police side, the one that we received was for Nosori. You know, for the Nasori town and the Nasori areas, that may come this evening, but that has not been confirmed yet. We have been advised to inform the residents of Nasori and along the river for those in low-lying areas to move to high ground because of the continuous rising of the river.
So when do you expect the final assessments to come in? Are you carrying out the aerial assessment or just ground?
Water has to recede first for the safety of the assessment teams before they go out, so that will take a couple of days before we can firm up in terms of the total damage cost for this weather system. Last one.
These relief supplies and food rations that's being funded out of the ministry's budget?
For those that are being built in the evacuation centres, yes. The Division of Commissioners are advised to provide rations to those who are living in evacuation centres.
Will government reactivate the PM's relief fund for them?
Yeah, the Prime Minister's relief fund is part of the allocations that is available in the ministry, but we have other resources within the ministry that we are also using to support it. Yeah.